Sorry, I gotta like go to the back.
Can somebody please let me know where we're at with the intro?
Oh, Abby!
Yeah?
Look, I did a thing. You like it?
Mike
Myers
wasn't even trying.
He
knows the cash grab.
No one cares about Mike Myers. It's all about don't care.
I'm done with you.
You can leave, but it's never okay.
Stop saying that.
The shredding has begun.
Oh my god.
Oh, hey Johnny.
Hey Chloe.
Oh, hey Jessica. Who's doing this? I'm not sure. Ask Wyatt. Who's doing the intro? Okay, thanks. Are you doing the intro?
That's the intro.
Good morning, Vipers. This is Raven Ibrahim, along with
Chloe Aguirre,
bringing you your morning announcements for Friday, November 20th.
Hey, Raven. What key won't open any door?
I really don't know.
A turkey!
Oh, don't migrate, Vipers. Here's your Thanksgiving weekly show.
Beedle, beedle, beedle.
Welcome one and all, welcome young and old, new and not new. Welcome, Brado, to my cooking show. This is Chloe's Cooking with you. All right, Vipers, I know Thanksgiving is right around the corner, and you're probably thinking, oh man, I don't know what to bring. I hate the traditional turkey, ham, stuffing, mashed potatoes, green beans, pumpkin pie, apple pie, blueberry pie, just a lot of pies. I know sometimes it's really, really hard to figure out what you're gonna make, but you know what? That's why I decided to make this show for you. I know these ones are gonna be a little bit intimidating. They're a little bit hard, but we're gonna take you through it step by step, and we're gonna work on them together, okay? Bear with me. I know it's really, really tough, but we will make it, Vipers. I promise you, Verado. All right, now the first thing we're gonna make, I will list our ingredients. So we need a loaf of bread. I can't believe it's not butter, but it actually is sort of butter. It's Bluebonnet butter. And a toaster. So, you might think, hey, what is this? I've never heard of this before, but I'll tell you what it's called. This is called toast, okay? So, what we're gonna do is we're gonna unravel the toast supplier bag of bread, AKA the loaf. I'm gonna let that spin around a little bit. It's nice to let it swing side to side, make sure it gets really comfortable with you, not make it too shy. So, we're gonna take a single slice, hold it like so, make sure to grab each corner, drop it into the slot. You see these slots right here? Yes, they're very, very, very electric. So let's make sure to just drop that right there. Nice, very nice, good job. Okay, I'm gonna take the next one. Two corners, drop it. Awesome. Take this sled right here. Hopefully you have a toaster just like mine. If not, I know they have smaller versions. All of them usually have the same components. What you use, you take the knob and you push it down really hard. And don't get your hair in the toaster. Okay, good. Sweet. The element right here is just patience. Nice, sweet patience. It's still going. I don't know how long it's gonna take. But it's still toasting. This is why you want to toast it. You know, you want to make sure you get that nice golden brown look. For those of you who don't know what toast is, it's when you make the bread a lot harder. So it's very, very, very crunchy and very, very appetizing for everyone. Once you practice it, it's easier and easier every time. I trust you. I trust myself as well.
Clap 3 times.
It's always good to just check the components you use. Oh God. I hate surprises. Whatever plate you need, I forgot to mention at the beginning, but you need a plate, obviously. What are you gonna eat on? So, we take the very golden brown toast. Listen, I know Star Wars is coming out, and I like my toast a little bit on the dark side. Yeah, so, Great. First step, totally complete. Now, for a little bit safety hazard, just make sure to put your toaster aside because I know it gets a little bit toasty in there. Now we take the blue bonnet. I can't believe it's not butter. Never gets old, right? All right, so now we're gonna take one slice of toast. And we're gonna take our knife with the butter. Make sure to always hold your piece of bread at a 45 degree angle. Thank you, Mr. Roof, for teaching me all that I know. I like to do is spread it nice and diagonal across the entire slice of bread. You know, you wanna get that nice visual, you know, like, yeah, I made this. And it's beautiful. I love it. Now, I know most of us aren't in the mood for maybe a salty thing, but maybe we're in the mood for more of a sweet, fruity taste. That's why. Schmucker's strawberry jam. You can never go wrong with it. Of toast. Wonderful job, guys. All right, now, make sure to DVR this. I know these steps are all really complicated and hard, so make sure to just keep that recording right there. You can look back on it. No problem, no judgment. Again, thank you all for tuning in today on Chloe's Cooking, and I hope you have a happy Thanksgiving, and I hope your lives are blessed with great gourmet meals just like the ones we made today. Goodbye.
Keep an eye out, Vipers. On December 7th and 8th, Johnson's will be taking final senior class graduation orders in the cafeteria during both lunches.
Be sure to stop by the front office to vote for the Inside Out photo contest.
Follow Digital Photo on Twitter at VHS Inside Out.
Tweet your votes, hashtag VHS Photo Vote, with your top three favorite photos.
Voting ends today.
Thanksgiving is coming up, which for most people means food and lots of it. Don't get me wrong, Thanksgiving is a wonderful holiday with a beautiful meaning behind it. I think it's important to spend a day giving thanks for everything we have in our lives. But it's not such a fantastic holiday for everyone. About 30 million people in the U.S. of any gender or age develop eating disorders. There are all different types that someone can have, like anorexia, bulimia, or binge eating. People develop these stereotypes for anyone who suffers from eating disorders, but in reality, it can affect all different types of people. Eating disorders are a serious illness that shouldn't be taken lightly. Even though Thanksgiving sounds perfect because of all the food, keep in mind that some of us fear it. If you or anyone you know is dealing with an eating disorder, please don't hesitate to get help. It could save your life.
Help out HOSA with their Social Innovations Competition. You can vote with your email address using the link below.
Hey, Chloe, does your family have any special Thanksgiving traditions?
Yeah, let's see what some of our Vipers' traditions are.
What are my Thanksgiving traditions? Usually, every year we go to my grandma's house and eat a lot, and that's about it. That's it, and then we go Black Friday shopping.
Every Thanksgiving, all the gentlemen, the dudes in the family, we all go golfing on Thanksgiving morning.
Brush my teeth, take a shower.
If I'm with my family, we always eat late in the afternoon on Thanksgiving Day. We play football in the morning, usually in the freezing cold because it's back in the Midwest. And then we watch football all night.
Oh, wow. My family from Wisconsin comes down and then we just eat at my house, I guess.
My Thanksgiving traditions, we usually just like get the turkey and we put it into the deep fryer and we just deep fry the turkey.
Right before we eat, after all the food's on the table, we all gather and hold hands and everyone says what they are grateful for.
Hug grandma.
We just kick it from like 12 in the afternoon to like midnight and then we go shop on Black Friday.
I mean, a tradition of ours also is I always get a turkey leg. I freaking demolish it.
If I'm with my wife's family, it's kind of the same thing. We just eat earlier and watch football longer and basketball that night.
I don't have any. Don't ask me this question.
Here is Noreen Jordan with your Turkey Day weather.
Good morning, Vipers. This is Jordan Hampton with your weather forecast for next week starting November 21st. This Thanksgiving week will be sunny with clear skies. Saturday will be a high of 78 and a low of 52. Sunday with a high of 77 and a low of 51. Monday, high of 76 and a low of 50. Tuesday, we have a high of 75 and a low of 52. As you can see, the weather is gradually decreasing throughout the week. Wednesday, we'll have a high of 68 and a low of 44. Thursday, high of 63 and a low of 42. And last, Friday with a high of 63 and a low of 41. Make sure to stay cozy and enjoy some hot turkey. This is Jordan Hampton signing off for KVHS.
On Monday, November 23rd, a former Verado student, Ben Carpenter, will be swinging by Verado to speak to students about admissions process for the Naval Academy. Stop by the guidance office to sign up.
Seniors, if you would like to order a 2016 panoramic picture, be sure to drop off your envelope in the bookstore. Are you an inspiring author? Are you interested in creative writing? Are you competitive? Then listen to this. Theater Club is hosting a playwriting competition with incredible prizes for first, second, and third places. If you are interested in participating, come to Theater Club from Tuesday from 3:15 to 3:45 for more information. See you there. Come support Verado's Club Explore at Chipotle on Thursday, December 3rd. Flyers will be handed out next week. Make sure to bring them and you'll get 50% of the proceeds. We'll go to Club Explore. Hiking Club meets today in room A12 after school. See you there.
Yearbook sales will be ending on December 18th. Be sure to order yours now.
See Ms. Seidner in room E28 for more information.
Senior ads are still available, Vipers.
Seniors, your first senior trip payment is due November 30th. Remember, space is limited.
All softball players, there will be no open field this week of Thanksgiving.
Open field will resume the following Wednesday, December 2nd.
Now, let's watch Chloe take a wipeout.
annual angel tree is up today in the front office. Make sure to pick up a tag and bring some gifts in by December 18th. Gift bags or unwrapped works best. Make sure to label your gift with the tag number.
Do you have any siblings that attend Verado with you? Do you want to be featured in the yearbook? If you went on any vacations together this year, be sure to email your pictures to vhspublications@gmail.com.
ACT testing is Saturday, February 6th, 7:45 a.m. to 2 p.m. You can get more information from Ms. Tiffany in the front office.
Let's take a look at what our Vipers are thankful for.
I'm thankful for my dogs. I'm thankful for my teachers, Dr. Maurer.
Thankful for my family and all of my teammates and the people who care about me, and my friends too. They're pretty cool.
I'm thankful for my family. I'm thankful for the school so I can learn a lot, and I'm thankful for the food that has been given to me, and I'm thankful for my teachers because they're really great.
I'm thankful for my family and the Verado football team for helping me get through my ACL injury. Also, I'm thankful for my girlfriend for all the love that she showed me and for just being her.
Thankful for a lot of things. Thankful for my life. Thankful for this job. I get to come to work and hang out with you all every day. I get paid to do that. That's pretty cool. My sister had a baby this year, so I'm an uncle. I'm really excited about that. And I don't know, I'm just thankful that I live in a world where I can be who I am and do what I want to do, and it's cool, it's great.
I'm thankful for food, friends, family, braces, eyebrows, makeup.
I'm really thankful for pizza. I have that like five times a week. I'm thankful for Lifetime because I live there.
I'm thankful for my teammates, my family, and my girlfriend.
I'm thankful for my family, my friends, obviously, and I'm grateful for the chance to play basketball.
I'm thankful for the classwork that I get assigned.
What I'm thankful for is my family and the great people I have. Thankful for the friends I have and all support.
Okay, without Mr. Walker, I would be lost. You know, I'm thankful for him and Dr. Maurer and Mr. Gilbert. I'm just thankful. Yeah. All right.
I think everybody would say they're friends and family, but I think me especially, we've had some family members going through some tough stuff over this year, and it's been really stressful and stuff, and I guess over Thanksgiving, it's just like a time for me to sit there and think about how lucky I am that there's not more stress and that I have a family to struggle with, and I'm just really thankful that they're there for me all the time.
Well, that's all we have for you this week, Vipers. Have a stuffing Thanksgiving, and don't forget, Verado Viper football goes to the semifinals for the first time ever. Come out to the sports room tonight at Millennium High School at 7 p.m.
Woo!